Okay, in this video I will show you how to schedule a SQL query and send the results by mail using Auto SQL. So here I have Auto SQL, and the first step when you have a new action is to set up a connection to your database. So here we need a connection string and a user and a password. And to help you build this, we can also select one of the installed OWC drivers on your machine. So we have plenty here. You can also add additional. If you click this link, you'll get a whole list of a lot of databases and their drivers, but you can also Google it, of course. But in this demo, we'll go for the SQL Server one. So I'm going to build a connection string, and then I'm going to end up in the wizard to connect to the database. So here I will put in my database server. I can put in my credentials if that need to be changed, some additional settings. And then you can finish and test your connection. It's successful, so we continue. And then you'll see that the connection string is also in here. If I test again from Auto SQL itself, it will also say it's successful. So then we can continue to the query. So here I prepared a master data check, which I want to run every Monday and to have the email and the results mailed to me. So if I test it from here, I do see four lines. So that's good. So that also works. Then if you go to output, you can select how you want to output the results. So you can choose the file type, Excel, CSV, or HTML. You can overwrite the existing file or append to it. And in this case, we're going to write it to this location. Then next is you can also send an email if you like. So here I tick the send email box. And I only want to have an email when I have more than zero results. So if my master data check doesn't return any data, it will not send me a mail. So here I have put in the details of my email. I can also put in placeholders. If I right click, I got a whole list of placeholders I can use, like the date of execution, the output path if you use it on a network, for example. But also you can put in the results. So here I put in the results with the 10th records first. So that's going to be part of the email body. Here I can choose to attach my Excel file or not, and I can also zip it if I like. There is some more settings for Excel specifically, if you want to use a template for a dashboard, for example, a worksheet specifically, or a cell specifically. But for now, we're going to just use the defaults. Now, if I run the action, I'm going to test if everything works. And as you can see already, a file is being created on my desktop, and now I also get the message that it has been successful. Then if I go to my email, I would also expect the email to arrive. There it is. So here I get the email that I just specified. And as you can see, the placeholder now also turns in a table with my actual results of the query. And I can directly see them from here, but I also have the Excel attachment. So if you save this as an action list of Auto SQL, you can also schedule it now. It uses underneath the Windows task scheduler. So if I click schedule, I already have one, but if I add a new one, I first can specify a trigger to say I always want to run it on Monday at 8 o'clock in the morning. Then I say OK. And then I also have to specify, or I could change the default name, but you don't have to. And you can choose with which user you need to run it. And also it defaults to run whether the user is logged in or not. So if you have it on a server, which is just constantly on, you can run it there as well. And then it will just run in the background. So if you say OK, then I have to put in my password again to make sure it can run. And then I have it scheduled.